Project Nujio'qonik is a game-changing project. Hopefully it's going to be the first project that supplies hydrogen from Canada to Germany as part of the Canada-Germany Hydrogen Alliance, which was signed in Stephenville on August 23rd, 2022. You know, it started with us investigating this project as a group of like-minded partners focused on sustainability, seeing an opportunity for Newfoundland and Labrador and for Canada. And it evolved from there.
John Risley is the common thread that links the four partners together. John and I were partners in Columbus Communications, a telecom company in the Caribbean and Latin America. John and Sean are partners in Horizon Maritime, which is an offshore services company, a mainstay in the marine industry in Newfoundland. John and Jean are partners in World Energy LLC, which operates biodiesel and sustainable aviation fuel plants on the west coast of the US.
We brought the team in from SK, and so the ownership team is now expanded to effectively five.
The environment, sustainability, and diversification all are in the forefront of the various businesses that are involved in the project.
Jean Jabolis and I have a project in Los Angeles, which is a big hydrogen user. And we were talking with the CEO of our hydrogen supplier a couple of years ago and said, we want to buy green hydrogen, which is hydrogen made with renewable energy, and can you sell us green hydrogen? And his answer was, no, I can't. I may be able to in 5 or 6 years' time. And if you want green hydrogen before that, you're going to have to make it yourself. And that was sort of a very much a door opener. And we said, okay, well, how do we do that? And he said, you go where you can produce renewable electricity very cost effectively.
Canada is so uniquely positioned with about one out of every 5 gallons of fresh water in the world, the lowest population density in the world, the amount of just incredible natural renewable resources, some of the best wind resources in the world. If this can't be done in Canada, it can't be done anywhere.
Project Nujio'qonik is actually Mi'kmaq for the area known as Bay St. George, but actually translates to where the sand blows. So we think that's very appropriate for a wind farm project on the west coast of Newfoundland.
We've got existing transmission corridors that all run into the Port of Stephenville, which we recently acquired. The Port of Stephenville is a key asset. There's a massive fresh water supply that's existing. That gives us a huge advantage. It's a brownfield site, a 400-acre site where we can fit the entire plant. If you look at the uniqueness of the site and these various factors that all come together and help us to drive the expedited schedule, that also drives the economics.
We think that Project Nujio'qonik has the highest potential to be realized quickly among the opportunities we have examined so far. SK EcoPlant and SK EcoEngineering feel a great sense of responsibility to be part of this ambitious project.
I wanted to get involved in this project because I don't think I'm that different from a lot of Newfoundlanders. I moved away 20 plus years ago to chase opportunities that I didn't think existed in Newfoundland. This project is a chance to bring people home, to raise their families, to have a future.
We've got the support of the local community, both First Nations and the community generally. And I think largely people respect the fact that, hey, this is a great opportunity, not just for me and my family, it's a great opportunity for the community generally. It's good for Newfoundland, it's good for the country, and it's good for the globe.
We're changing the world. I think the opportunity for Newfoundland and Labrador, not just with respect to our project, but with respect to standing up this green hydrogen industry, is massive. And all levels of government are coming together to support it in ways that we've never seen before. We enjoy an immense amount of support from the local communities. We have a wonderful relationship with the Halibut First Nation, hoping to build on that and create meaningful and lasting benefits for the Halibut members.
I think it sets the stage for a much more permanent, sustainable business that people can plan their lives around. And you then say, okay, well, what's the future of the renewable energy industry and how long is it going to last? And my answer is, how long is the wind going to blow?
The prosperity that can result from this, the possibilities are almost endless.
The status quo isn't going to cut it in energy. We're going to have to change. We're going to have to bring things that are different than what we currently have.
we firmly believe that we can successfully create this historic green hydrogen and ammonia project together.
You know, the environment and sustainability is not just our responsibility, it should be everybody's responsibility.
If we are worried about it, then it's incumbent upon us to actually do something about it. So this is doing something about it.